Hi, can I please get a medium iced latte?
Yeah.
Decaf, please, with almond milk.
Yeah, you feel?
That's it, thank you.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Hey,
was
that just a medium
iced
latte?
Yeah.
That's just $5.
Thank you. Thanks. Thank you. Thanks, you too. Okay, let's find a park. Hi guys, welcome back. So I have a massage in about 20 minutes. I thought we could do a little catch-up Q&A. I put a question box up my story probably a week ago now, asking you guys to send me some questions. So I'm going to answer them. I need to take my Invisalign out because I got a little iced coffee to drink with you guys. So let's get started. I feel like I have a lot to catch up with you guys about, and that's why I was like, you know what, for this week's YouTube video, I'm just gonna do a little Q&A because I feel like I haven't done a Q&A in so long, like a proper just sit down Q&A. Okay, someone said go-to foundation, on the hunt for a good coverage foundation. So on a day-to-day basis, I don't wear foundation. I just wear flawless filter. I'm very lucky with my skin, so when I'm wearing foundation, I don't really wear it for coverage. I more wear it just to match like my face to my neck, like when I tan. I will say though, when I'm like, oh, I want to be like really beat, like nice, like intense glam, I will use the NARS Light Reflecting Foundation. That is like the best. So probably those two. Why the switch to gym from Pilates? So if you guys know, I started going to Pilates and then all of a sudden now I'm at the gym. So basically, some backstory. I used to go to the gym four years ago before I got glandular fever. So I got glandular fever in year 12, got really sick and had to stop going. But literally up until then, I was going like 6 times a week. I was obsessed with it. Like this was my mental health. Like I just loved it. Like it was just, I don't know, part of the day that I just loved. Like I looked forward to it. And I just loved how it made me feel. It put me in a good mindset for the day. And I think during year 11 and I guess like the start of year 12 before I got sick, I was in such a bad place mentally. Like I can't even explain to you. So I think that was like my one little escape, you know, like my like me time, because I was so like honed in on studying and like that was the only time in the day that I let myself have time for me. Like not that studying wasn't for me, but like I loved studying, but like at the rate that I was doing it, like obviously it took a really big toll on me. Like I was studying, like if I wasn't at school in a class, I would be studying, and if I wasn't going to sleep, I'd be studying. So the gym was like the only time I really gave myself, and I just loved how it made me feel. But basically, wow, that was a detour. I started going to Pilates because it was like, it's been like 3 years since I got glandular fever, maybe even 4, can't really remember. But I my immune system is just cooked from glandular fever. Like it's just so cool. A lot of shit has gone wrong. And I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna start Pilates, like ease into it, blah, blah, blah. Pilates is not easy, but I was like, you know, I feel like I can go up my own rate. So I just started going to Pilates, and then I was like, you know what, like I feel like I'm ready to go back to the gym. Like I feel like I'm there. So I started going back and now I'm loving it. So I need to cancel my Pilates membership. I was just gonna keep both, but I just haven't been going to Pilates. So, cause I was like, oh yeah, I'll do both. And I just haven't been, I've just been loving the gym. So it's no real reason. I just felt like I was ready to go back to the gym because that's what I love doing. Sorry, I had to turn the car on because it's so hot today. So I need the aircon on. I know I have a zip up on, but I need the aircon on. I already know all the questions are about your mans. I'm so happy for you. So I may have done a little bit of a soft launch on my Instagram. I'm not going to say much about it because I've kept it private since 2022. In saying that, it was like the very end of 2022. So it kind of started the start of 2023, end of 2022. I've kept it private for that long. I've managed to keep him a secret. The only reason I decided to share him with you guys is because, I mean, I don't know, I just feel like I wanted to slowly just like let you guys know I had a partner. But I don't know, I just felt like it was the right time to just kind of like be like, hey, I have a partner, I'm just letting you know. Not saying that he'll ever be posted fully, but I just kind of wanted to like soft launch just to be like, hey, I have a partner, letting you guys know, so that if in a few years we get engaged or like have a baby, you're not like, what the fuck? So not that that's like on the cards right now. Don't freak out if like all the tea time page is gonna be like, oh my god, Zoe's having a fucking baby. No, I'm just saying in a few years, I didn't want you guys to be like, what the fuck? I didn't even know you had a partner. So that was kind of my thought process. I just felt like it was the right time. But yeah, we've been together for, yeah, over a year now. He is the best person to ever exist. That's all I'm going to say because I'm going to keep that part of my life really private. And I hope you guys respect that. A lot of you haven't respected that so far. A lot of investigation is going on. But yeah, it's the best. I'm the happiest I've ever been. Even before him, I was super happy. So, you know, you guys know I preach like single life. I know you guys like can't believe you have a man when you literally say you hate men. It's like, that's not really how it works. Like, I don't know. I feel like a lot of people are just like twisting my words. I know I was very anti-boyfriend, but when you find the right one, it's different. Do you know what I mean? Like, I was very anti like being desperate and looking for a partner. I have known him for 8 years, and that's all the information I'm gonna give. But I've known him for a very long time. He is the best person ever. My family loves him. I love his family. It's just, I couldn't be happier. But yeah, I'm not really, don't really plan on ever fully posting him. 90% of these questions are about him. Like, tell us about your mans. Who is he? Like, I'm not ever gonna tell you guys who he is. Like, he doesn't do social media. His screen time is like 40 minutes a day. He just has no idea about that side. Like, he just knows me as Soph because we've known each other for so long. And that's what I think is so nice about it, is like, he just knows me as like Soph from school, like when I was fucking like bald in year 7. So that's really nice. But yeah, I'm never really gonna fully post him. It's never gonna be like, there's never gonna be relationship content. Like, he's never gonna be in my videos. That's just a part of my life that I love and that I really cherish, because on days when social media really takes a toll on me, I can go home to the love of my life and know that I'm like comfortable and safe. And not that if like I posted him, it wouldn't be like that, but it's just like a nice little private sanctuary that I love. And like, we just don't talk, like we talk about like obviously my work and my job, like, but it's just like a nice, like, he's just like a part of me that I just want to like cherish and like protect. Like, it's just like a nice little, it's like just nice having one thing, you know. I feel like everything I do is being posted, and that's my choice. Like, I'm not saying that's anyone else's, that's my choice, but it's just nice to have one little thing. And it's also really funny, like, I feel like everyone, like, not everyone, but a lot of people think that they know everything about me. And it's like, well, you didn't even know that I had a partner for a year and a bit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just funny that it's like, you only know what I post. So it's like, it's just kind of like funny to kind of like be like, well, you didn't even know that. So like, I kind of choose what I want you guys to see. Wow, tangent. But that's all I'm gonna say. You're never gonna, like, I'm never gonna post him. So kind of semi like give up investigating. But yeah, he is the best person ever. That's all I'm gonna say. But we love him. How long did it take for you to start All For Mimi, then your first collection to come out? It took a fucking long time. Like, the amount of money we have spent just like down the drain on, like, obviously not down the drain because it's like been a learning experience, but like on so many like samples and starting with like management kind of places that kind of do it for you, and just nothing worked. And we were like, we just need to do this on our own. Like, we have no experience in fashion besides being an influencer. I've never been really interested in fashion, like on that type of level, like having my own business. That was never like a dream when I was a kid. I wanted to be a doctor, so this is all really new to me. Mum, like, she, all her past professions have nothing to do with fashion, so it's very new. I would say about 2 years from the first like thought, and so much time and money just down the drain, but obviously worth it now. I'm glad you guys love it, and the stuff coming, I can't even. I'm so excited. I have a massage in 5 minutes, so I might go have my massage and come back and finish it, because we have a lot of more questions to get through. Hey, I have a booking at 11:35. Am I able to move that to 12?
Yeah, sure, it should be fine.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, see you. Bye.
Slay, I just moved my appointment to 12. Have you ever had a bad experience with a follower? Yes, all the fucking time, especially when alcohol is involved. I feel like I've talked about this before, but I have like a few stories that kind of stick out. I've had people grab me, I've had people kiss me, obviously non-consensual. I've had people yell at me, like try and like fight me. Like, it's honestly been incredible. Like, it's been a big eye opener, but it's usually when alcohol is involved or testosterone is involved. But yeah, all the time. So that's nice and fun. should I have a boyfriend by now? No. And like, this is what I will still preach to you guys, is like, you do not need a man to make you happy. And I think that's why people are so confused. Like, I thought you like were so against getting a boyfriend. It's like, no, I am just so for making sure you are so happy before you know what I mean? Like, mum always says, like, fill your own pie, like your pie, and you have like little pieces of it. Fill up your own pie before you add to it. Like, your boyfriend should be like, you should be like, I'm so happy with my life. And then he or she, your partner, should just be like an addition. Do you know what I mean? Like, it shouldn't be like, they shouldn't fill a piece of your pie. Like, you should already be so happy and just like content without them. And then they should obviously they can be like, they can add so much to your life. But it's like, what I'm trying to preach to you guys is like, if they were removed, obviously you're gonna be a bit sad, like I would with my partner, but like, you'd still be you, like you'd still, you know what I mean? Like, they shouldn't complete you. Like, you should already be complete, you should already be happy. I feel like there's a lot of people out there, they're like, I need a boy, like I'm so lonely and unhappy without one. It's like, you need to work on that before you get a partner. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I'm saying to you guys. Like, and I was so happy and content before I found my Brian. I'm just gonna call him that, you know, Sophia and Cinzia. If you know, you know, they call the boys of the world Brians. I was so incredibly happy and content before I met my Brian. And I think that's why, just speaking for him, like, you come off so attractive when you're like working on yourself and like you just have your shit together. Like, that's attractive. And like, when you're so happy without someone, like, that's attractive. Like, you radiate bad bitch energy. So I think like, that's what I'm trying to preach to you guys. It's like, you do not need a boyfriend. You never need a boyfriend. They will come into your life. Like, when I posted a relationship video the other day, like, it was like the, sorry, I just got a message and I was like, what the fuck? What was I saying? I posted a video basically with him in it. And someone was like, oh, tips like on how to get a boyfriend. And I'm like, just exist and work on yourself and they will come into your life whenever the time is right. Do you know what I'm saying? What advice would you give to girls that are turning 24 years old this year? I'm 20, so I cannot give 24 year olds advice. I literally just turned 20 and like 2 months ago I was still a teenager, so I'm just gonna not answer that. What location is the Mimi warehouse? You know, I'll just give you a pin drop. I'll just give you an exact pin drop and you can come visit. Some of these questions are ridiculous. Is all your Define activewear PR or did you buy it? No, all my Define activewear I bought. I think the first time I bought off them, they might have noticed my name and chucked a few extra goodies in, but pretty much all the activewear, pretty much all the Define activewear that you see on my gym content is me buying it. A lot of stuff that I wear, you guys, like I buy, like I spend so much money on shopping. And I feel like a lot of people think that like, oh, she wouldn't even have to buy anything. It's like, I buy a lot of my shit. And I also say no to a lot of gifting. So it kind of, you know, how much do you weigh if it's not a secret? I'm not gonna answer that. Like, I don't understand some of these questions. They're so fucking funny to me. Are you gonna be creating any more clothing items soon? P.S. Love you for real, bae. Love you too, Maddie. Yes, like the stuff coming, by the way, like we don't even have samples for this. It's just like in the works. But right now I am designing, we're designing like a year ahead pretty much. So like I'm trying to think 2024 summer right now and it is so hard, like as in like 2024 spring summer, do you know what I'm saying? But basically the stuff coming, like I feel like it was always going to be a clothing business, but we just happened to do the swim and pajama launch first. So I think people have in their head like, oh, it's like a pajama company, but like it's not, like it's all clothing. We just happened to launch that first. So I feel like people are gonna have like a kind of like a shock as to what is about to come out, but like it's a good shock, do you know what I mean? But it's just like not, I feel like it's not expected. Macca's coffee is the best. Like if you say you don't like Macca's coffee, you're just a coffee snob because it's so fucking good. But I wish they didn't add sweetener into it. Like I always forget to say no sweetener because I didn't know they just like added into it. Concert lineup for this year so far. Okay, I need to go to my calendar for this because I lucky forget what concert tickets I buy. So I have Festival. I'm going to sold out. So I've got that. And that's like Bryson Tiller, Summer Walker, Party Next Door. So excited for that. Then I bought tickets to a Boogie with a Hoodie. I hate saying that name because it's so fucking funny. I bought tickets to his concert in Melbourne, but I didn't really check my calendar and turns out I can't go. I have a friend's 21st. So I need to sell those tickets. If you're looking for 2 tickets to that concert in Melbourne on the 12th of April, let me know because I'll sell them to you. Then I'm going to SZA in April. So fucking excited. Like I love SZA. I'm actually going to the ballet. also in May. And then I don't have any until November, and then we have Coldplay in November. So that's really fucking exciting. I feel like a lot of the shit I go to is very last minute though, so there'll probably be more than that. Hey.
Hey, Bobby.
Hey.
When are you going to the shops?
Oh. And I've got my massage at 12, and then...
Slay girly. What's... Is mom with you?
No.
Oh, she's getting a massage.
Is she?
Yeah, I thought she was going to get a massage.
Oh, maybe. I might see her in there. I'm booked in at 12.
Oh, I swear she literally told me she was going to get a massage today.
Oh, Slay. I haven't talked to her. But yeah, her neck is cooked. Neck. Yeah, it was cooked last night. What are you doing today?
Nothing. I've got to get my nails done for the wedding.
Oh, yeah. Where are you going to go?
I don't know.
Interesting. Where'd you go for brekkie? Oh, yeah. Slay.
Yeah, it did slay. It was good.
Okay, well, I'm going to... Jackie's a bit hung?
Yeah. Say hello, Jack.
I'll find out.
Hi, Jackie. At 12, and I'm getting a 45-minute massage, and then I'm not doing anything.
And then what are you doing after?
Nothing. But he's at golf, so I don't know.
Well, I might catch up with you after the massage.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bye, bub. Honestly, sometimes my sister calls me for the most random shit. Like, what the fuck was the point of that phone call? Okay. How do you find the motivation to consistently get to the gym? I need to get back into it. I haven't gone to the gym this week, probably 4 days now, because I was away in the Gold Coast, and then I got back and I was tired. I only like to go when I... It's like, it depends. Like, if I'm at home and I'm like, oh, I really don't want to go, I'm like, so go. But like, if I'm genuinely like tired from like traveling or like not feeling well, like immune wise, because my immune system is like this. If you've got it on me, you know, like some days you're feeling great, like $1 million. Oh God, a car full of guys just pulled up. Cause I'm parked at KFC right now. And I don't, I can definitely see my camera. I'm just gonna sit like this for a bit until I go inside. Oh, it's my worst nightmare. Oh my God, I swear 17 people just got out of that car. Oh my God, they're literally 11. Never mind, I don't even know how they're driving a car. Yeah, so like, basically what I'm trying to say is, don't like I know it may seem because I'm always posting gym content, but like, and sometimes I do go like 6 times a week, but like this week I've only gone like twice. And it's Sunday today, and usually I love going on Sundays, and I'm just like, I can't be fucked, because I had a party last night, I went to bed at probably 2 a.m, woke up at like 10, so I got a good sleep, but like, I'm just like, you know what, today, can't be fucked, I'm not gonna go, maybe I'll go this Arvo, but like, I just go when I feel like it, and if I'm at home, and it's just pure laziness, then I'll like, force myself to go, but like, if I don't feel good, I'm just not gonna go, because I don't want the gym to become like a negative space. Obviously, I always feel better after, but like, when I'm sick, I don't want to be pushing myself and then get like full on infection, because that's what happens with autoimmune. Like, I'm on the verge of infection like pretty much 24/7. So if I drink, smoke, obviously, not that I would ever do that anyway, but like if I drink, smoke, work out, like overexert myself, I'll get an infection. So basically, finding motivation, I love the gym, so I don't really have to kind of push myself, which is nice. Like, most days if I'm feeling fine, I want to go because I genuinely love the gym. So that's probably not helpful, but basically what I'm trying to say is, I don't really know, but don't think that I'm going every day, because like, I posted a gym TikTok today that was from like a week ago, I just happened to post it today, so don't think that I'm going every day. Do you know what I'm saying? How's your autoimmune issues going? I can see you're back in the gym, which is awesome. Yeah, I'm very lucky, I'm back in the gym, it's going good. I've been seeing a respiratory doctor, and I have a nasal spray that I take, and that's been really helping to help me breathe, because also my nose is like apparently 100% just for decoration, it doesn't work. So the nasal spray helps me breathe. So yeah, it's been better, but like I said, last night didn't really get a good sleep, went to bed at 2 a.m. so today I'm feeling kind of shit. Like, it just depends on like my routine, and like sometimes it's just up and down depending on what I eat. Like, if I'm eating really good to my intolerances, like if I eat gluten, sick as a dog. Like, so it just depends on how I'm managing it, you know? When did you have your first kiss? I didn't have my first kiss till I was in year 12. Slow. You look so clean. Haha, what is your maintenance routine? I am, honestly, I know everyone that knows me right now is laughing at that, because I am, like, if you could see my car right now, it is a dump. My house is a dump. Like, I will fully accept that. I am the, I wouldn't say I'm dirty, I'm just messy. Like, clothes everywhere. If there's food, though, I have to clean up the food. Like, I won't leave food or, like... That's mainly because I have literally a fear of cockroaches. If I didn't have a fear of cockroaches, I probably would. But I'm the messiest person ever. I wouldn't say I'm dirty or, like, unhygienic. Like, with myself, I'm clean. But, like, with my spaces, like, clothes everywhere. Like, last night, I had a mental breakdown of what to wear to the party. So I was, like, throwing clothes everywhere. But, like, yeah, like, food-wise and, like, cleaning up after myself, my mom's definitely helping me right now, is good. But messiness-wise, I'm really messy, but I'm not dirty, if that makes sense. So don't, not everything you believe is, like, if you see me with a clear background in my TikTok, just outside of the border of the TikTok will be, like, a pile of clothes that I've just pushed out of the frame. Do you know what I'm saying? What Yoichi flavor do you get? So... My favorite is taro, but they literally never have it. They've only had it once when I went, and that was in Melbourne, but that's my by far favorite taro. They never have it, so usually I get signature tart and salted butterscotch. But salted butterscotch is probably my favorite besides taro, but they never have it. Look like you're friggin' glowing. There's been a huge shift in you, and I am all for it. Thank you. That is so kind. Yeah, I've been really just like, I've been really happy. Like, I don't know. I've just been really taking care of myself and blocking out a lot of the hate, which is nice because fuck me, that can be brutal sometimes. But I've been really learning to not let it affect me, and I think that's what's making me glow, you know. What football team do you go for? AFL. I go for Collingwood. Wait, AFL season starts soon, does it not? It starts 2 weeks. AFL season starts. I don't really know much about it. I do kind of know the rough rules, and that's why I kind of enjoy watching it. But I do go for Collingwood only because when I moved to Melbourne, the group that I was kind of like friends with and with were all either like partners of Collingwood players or Collingwood players. So I just kind of like was pushed into that before I like lived in Melbourne. Like if you live in New South Wales, you know, if you live in New South Wales, you know, no one watches AFL. Like it's mainly a Melbourne, well, mainly not a New South Wales thing, at least where I live. So yeah, when I moved to Melbourne, everyone was like, you're going to get into an AFL. And I was like, bro, no, I'm not. And then it turns out I did. But yeah, I go for Collingwood. Slay. Go Pies. Where do you see yourself in the next 3 to 5 years? Hopefully with some beautiful children, living in my dream house. I'm wanting to build a house. So that is my goal. AFM thriving. Stable and steady, because right now we're learning a lot of shit and I just can't wait till the processes are just smooth. And yeah, slay. Do you think you'll always stay blonde, or would you ever consider going brunette? To be honest, I literally fucking look brunette right now. I promise I'm not. I will always be a blondie through and through. You will never see me brunette. Opinion on Eshays. What the fuck are these questions? Seriously. These are about... Oh, are you going to Dom Dollar? Yes, I'm going to Dom Dollar. That's the other concert that I forgot to tell you. I'm going to Dom Dollar. I need to put it in my calendar. I also need to transfer my friend for that because I just realized she bought the tickets and I haven't transferred it yet. But yeah, most of these questions are about my boyfie, the Brian. So I'm just going to not answer anymore because I honestly can't escape them. They're all about him. So I hope you enjoyed. I need to go home and edit this because it is midday right now and this will be going out at 5 the same day. So I need to go home and edit it. But I love you. I hope you have an amazing week. This is going to be going out on Sunday Arvo. So I hope the next week is amazing for you. I love you. Thank you for watching. Yeah. Stay tuned for more Q&As. If you liked these, let me know. So let me know if you like the vlogs and I'll keep them up. But yeah, love you.